Hey guys, this is David Kwan. Last week, I explored this idea of a universe without any gods and what that would mean. And to me, what it meant was that in a universe without supernatural beings, universe is simply what it is, and reality is what it is. Life exists none other than just for life's sake itself. And I argue that it's better this way, because then things make a whole lot of sense. A lot of things in the universe, you know, are incredibly, incredibly fucked up. But oftentimes, the end results of evolution through natural selection can be quite beautiful. Whether something is good, bad, evil, or just, that's what we assign to the universe, not what the universe imposes on us. Universe simply is, without an ultimate agenda of any sort. Well then, what about a universe in which gods or even godlike beings exist? What are the implications for a universe with the god? And that's what I want to talk about here. First off, before this thought experiment can go anywhere, one important thing has to be addressed. If God exists, then which God is it? Is it a single God, like the one described in the Torah or in the Quran? Or are there multiple entities, like the Greek religion of Zeus, Ares, Athena, or is it like Hinduism with goddesses and gods? Is it a god that is one being but exists in form of Trinity, as argued by certain Christian denominations? Are such beings all-powerful, all-knowing, or are they just beings that we would consider to be godlike because compared to our human abilities, they are so much more able and sophisticated? I think these questions are extremely important, because what implications we can derive from a universe with a god depends largely on which god it is, what kind of god it is. So first, before even talking about a god or gods, let's talk about godlike beings. And by that I mean, imagine a being like Superman or Wonder Woman. I know they're fictional characters, but let's just imagine for a second that in this universe, there are beings who are that powerful. These kinds of beings aren't necessarily gods, but compared to us humans, they are certainly much more capable and more powerful. For example, in some comics, it's revealed that Superman has enough power to cause a supernova and destroy entire planets. He has the power to destroy a planet. Now, certainly, that's extremely powerful. If a being like Superman existed right next to me, I would certainly consider him as a godlike being. And what would that universe be like? What would the world be like if the world had someone like Superman? Well, we know characters like Superman and Wonder Woman to be very noble characters. They're usually portrayed as being really morally upright and do everything in their power to uphold their ideal of justice. And it usually matches with our ideals of justice. So perhaps having beings like these in our world might actually be a really good thing. But then, think about it. Is it really? For example, what happens if you or I disagree with Superman? What if Superman believes that going to war against Afghanistan is the morally right thing to do? And what happens if you disagree with that? What happens to the Afghanistans who don't want to be involved in the war? Imagine a scenario in which Superman says, you know what, North Korea is being a dick. We need to send them a message by sending a nuclear missile. And the President of the United States is like, I don't really think that's a good idea, Superman. Superman says, you may have a point, but in my idea, in my opinion, we need to nuke North Korea. Are you going to do it or not? The President, does he have a choice? So here's what happens. If you disagree with Superman, this is what happens. Tough shit. Tough shit for those who disagree with the godlike being like Superman. You may disagree, but it has no bearing on the being who is so much more powerful than you. Whatever these demigods say, goes. Do you disagree with their morals? Do you think Superman should take other course of action? Sorry, but that doesn't matter at all. Superman says it's the right thing to do, so it's going to be the right thing to do. And this is without even posing a scenario in which a godlike being is not noble, is not morally upright? What happens if Superman turns evil? What if a godlike being is like the Hulk and can retaliate based on his mood? So somebody makes Hulk angry, and because he can't control his emotions, you know, what happens then? And what if a godlike being is actually someone who's evil or who doesn't care about human beings or the universe? Someone like Thanos. Someone like Galactus. Well then, we're fucked. Seriously, we're fucked if a being like that exists. Because then, we're at the whimsy of extremely powerful godlike beings from whom we're absolutely powerless to fight against. Even to beings who are not necessarily gods, but just more powerful and more sophisticated than us, are beings who can treat us as their little playthings. And we would have no choice but to go along with it. Their morality becomes our morality, because if we disagree, then they will destroy you, or they will silence you. So, with this in mind, one thing to me is absolutely clear. If even godlike beings exist in our universe, we would exist under their coercion, under their permission. If we live, it would be because they allow us to live. If we are happy, it would only be because they allow us to be happy. We need their permission for anything. So then, what about actual gods and God? So let's move on to polytheism and drop the issue of godlike beings. If the universe came to be because of multiple gods all vying for power, with some of the gods working together and some working independently, perhaps that could possibly explain why the universe may seem so elegantly designed, and yet why oftentimes it's messy and chaotic. The existence of such higher beings could be used to explain why the universe is the way it is. But that begs the question, well then, what do we human beings have to do with their existence? What about it? So what? What do these gods want from us? Does it want to do anything with us? Why would they possibly be interested in our own affairs? And you know, I believe that we should wish that such gods don't care to do anything with us human beings, or any other sentient beings on this planet for that matter. Because once they do get involved, no matter how noble their intentions, we ultimately become their playthings. If these are gods that are powerful enough to create this universe and to create life, then we don't stand a fucking chance against them. If they tell me to burn incense and give praise and glory to their names, if they tell me to do that in order that I live or in order that I get good grades in graduate school, what choice do I have? If they order me to murder an abortion doctor because they think that abortion is immoral, do I have a choice? Can I tell a god, no, I'm not going to do that? Just like with godlike beings, if gods become involved in human affairs, no matter what my belief system is, no matter what my moral compass says, their will and their morality will be imposed on me. It's a form of coercion I have no way of resisting, because if I do, then I'm dead or they'll punish me. So with that in mind, let's finally move to monotheism, particularly the God of Abraham. If this was the God that created everything in the universe, then we have to conclude that there is an ultimate reason for everything being the way it is. Why, out of so many trillions of observable planets, why, out of all that, Earth is the only planet that can support carbon-based life forms? God is the reason and the answer. There's an answer behind this, and He's the answer, because He made things to be this way. He's a timeless, causeless being that knows all things in the future and all things in the past. With such a God, there is a purpose to everything. Why Holocaust ended up killing over 6 million people? Why Stalin ended up rising to power and ordered the death of over 20 million people? Why a baby can be born with a genetic defect that can kill them in 10 months' time? We can ask this question, why is this so beautiful? Why is the universe so beautiful? Or why did this tragic event have had to happen? And if this singular God exists, then all these questions have ultimate, definite answers. There's a reason behind everything. There's a purpose behind everything. In a universe where such a God exists, you would be absolutely correct to say that everything happens for a reason. And this reason that you're implying is more than just the naturalistic reason of cause and effect. In this case, you really have to wrestle with justifying tragic, horrific events to being potentially positive things that are in line with God's ultimate plan and goals. In a universe where God exists, you are no longer the one assigning what is good or evil to the things of the universe. You no longer have that right. It's God who decides. It's God who assigns those things. And it's God who assigns those things to you. Do you think sacrificing your son is morally reprehensible? Do you think it's wrong to do that? Well, if God's the one assigning morals to you, and if God's the one telling you to do it, then does your opinion even matter anymore? You're just a tiny, tiny little part to God's ultimate agenda. If you don't follow along, God has no use for you, and your life has no meaning at all. So the ultimate point I want to make is that if God, gods, or even godlike beings exist in our universe, then our lives become trivial. Not only our lives, but also the lives of all sentient beings. Because their lives are just simply part of an agenda that we don't yet know or understand, or can't understand. The trivialization of life also makes it easier to justify the taking away of a life. If God wills it, murder can be justified. Rape can be justified. Genocide can be justified. After all, who are we to question God's morals? If God or gods exist, our lives and the universe would have purpose, sure, but it wouldn't be our own purpose. It would be whatever these higher beings want it to be. There would be an ultimate morality that would be totally imposed on us, even though that ultimate morality may totally go against our own personal moral compass. So considering all these implications, I really no longer can understand why so many people are so desperate to cling on to the belief that God exists and that God has a plan for us, as if that's such a great, optimistic thing to believe in. So those are my thoughts. Share whatever comments or questions you may have on that, but I really do believe if there is such a thing as God in this universe, then we really have to wrestle with this fact that, well, then we no longer really control our lives, and our lives don't really matter to us, but only to a God or God-like beings who are imposing their will on us or who have their plan for us. We don't know their plan. We don't know what they're going to do. You might disagree with the plan, personally, but you can't act against it because, well, they're more powerful than you. Who are you to fight against? Resistance is totally futile. So with that, I will end this video. Hope you enjoyed what I had to say. Cheers.